Hi folks, very interesting conversation. I have Gurmeet here. Gurmeet is a guru of Africa, so Guru Gurmeet. Interesting report. He was on a panel in the NASCOM Emerge event, and that's how we are catching up with him. Gurmeet, talk a little bit about Africa. So why is Africa so important? What are the statistics that you had some very interesting stats about Africa.
Yeah, so I mean, Africa is a combination of 54 countries put together with a billion plus population. And an economy of close to $6 trillion put together.
Mm-hmm.
And it's coming up really well because of the demand which it has created for itself and the various ICT-led innovation that is happening. So in Africa, you have a concept where the governments are moving away from the traditional economies to a knowledge-based economy, and how it's not just moving from traditional economy to knowledge-based economy, but how they're using ICT products to create innovative solutions to support their traditional economies. That is what is happening there. And that's where we see a lot of play for small and medium-sized Indian enterprises to come and showcase their innovative strategies and position themselves as leaders in the magic quadrant out there.
Mm-hmm. Very nice. And what are the things that, typically, how well do Indians fare? What is it about India as a market or as an industry or as entrepreneurs that makes us succeed in Africa?
So Indians per se are viewed in a very high level out there because of our forefathers who went there as teachers out there. So the concept of whole India is that, we are treated as, technology gurus.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of them have, gone through universities where they were taught by Indian teachers.
Mm-hmm.
So the Indian per se is kept in a very high light itself.
Very nice.
Which becomes the selling point. The other thing which is also driving business in favor of Indians is the robust growth of Indian IT industry across the globe. That is also, put a stamp on the conviction that they have.
Nah.
So for an Indian entrepreneur to enter Africa, it's a rather easy phase because the brand India plays a lot in their evaluation effort and gives the credibility out there.
Very interesting. And is that changing because of all the China stuff that's happening right now?
So China, it is changing, but it's primarily on the quid pro quo. So China, what they do is they go to the countries and they say, okay, we'll build a road for you. In lieu of it, we'll take the uranium or the mining, or we'll take this from you. But China has not been able to enter the knowledge-based industry.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, in terms of they will come and say that we'll create a technology park for you, but we'll have to put all the Chinese equipment in the technology park.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is something which is creating a flood in India's this thing.
Mm-hmm.
But in terms of hardcore products or support, I think she's still by far the leaders out there.
Okay. And what kind of business models are succeeding there right now?
So it's primarily a partnership-based model.
Uh-huh.
So you have to work with a partner out there who understands the local context, who can manage the relationship at his end, do the social networking part of it. And obviously you have to train the people to take on a larger role if you want to set up a long-term vision in a particular country.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. So is there a difference between entering Africa as a small entrepreneur versus a large, what kind of advice would you give to somebody that's not very big and that has to think twice before they put in money? So what kind of a storyline would you sort of tell them? What should they be thinking about?
I think a small entrepreneur, if he has got an innovative solution, a unique value proposition, so it's very easy for them. But if you have a run-of-the-mill, say a SAP installation service or a Microsoft product, then it's going to be very difficult because there are people who are already there doing that. So what those guys are looking out for is, innovative solution that can help them maximize the value that they derive out from the relationship. The other thing which is very important there is they don't have any legacy systems to back out on. So everything is on a clean slate. So for an entrepreneur, especially small and medium entrepreneur, it becomes easy because you are more flexible. You have the advantage of higher technologies that you can play on. And if you create a value proposition, then it's a win-win solution for all.
Very cool. Thank you very much. Great insight. Really appreciate it.